Hi guys, welcome to Healesville Sanctuary. Today I'm going to be introducing you to a few of our echidnas, so feel free to come on in and we'll have a look, see who's out. My name's Craig, I'm one of the echidna keepers here at the sanctuary. I'm going to be introducing you to three of our echidnas who live in this exhibit together. So we have Lincoln, Blondie and Sunny. Being a little bit cooler weather these days, we're not 100% sure that they're all going to be out of bed, but we'll see who we can find. They are enjoying the sunshine at the moment, so we're going to try to lure them over with a little bit of their favourite foods. So feeding our echidnas this food that's made especially for them, so it's basically a meat meal mix. We get it in as a powder. Mix it with water and it makes up this nice, gooey, porridgey looking food. Doesn't look the nicest, but it's something the echidnas really like and it's a complete diet for them. So you can see that nice long tongue there. Really perfect for reaching into those ant nests or those termite mounds. But the interesting thing about echidnas, you've got that long beak that you can see there, that snout, but they actually don't have any teeth, so they'll actually rely on that tongue to bring the food into a really tiny mouth, so their mouth basically opens only about as wide as that tongue. There's no teeth, they just kind of need to grind that up inside the mouth without the use of any teeth. We're using these congs just as a different way to deliver that food for our echidnas. So a lot of people might think of these echidnas, a short-beaked echidna, as quite uniquely Australian, but this species is also found throughout Papua New Guinea as well. And Papua New Guinea also has some other species called long-beaked echidnas, which are pretty similar looking to these guys, a little bit larger, and as the name suggests, a bit of a larger beak. But these short-beaked echidnas are also found in Papua New Guinea, so they are not just an Australian animal, although we probably do like to claim them sometimes. A lot of people do ask, because of their appearance with their spiky look, whether they are related to hedgehogs or to porcupines. They're not closely related to those animals. They're actually from a group of animals called monotremes, which is basically just echidnas and platypuses, and they are actually egg-laying mammals. So they do have a pouch, but it's not a proper pouch like marsupials. The females will actually have kind of a more like a temporary pouch when they lay an egg, which they can carry that around in and eventually incubate that. Coming into winter, once the weather is starting to cool down like it has been, we're going to start seeing our echidnas less and less, so it's a good opportunity at the moment to see Lincoln and to see Blondie, because we might not be seeing much of them in the coming months. They do tend to go underground, go into kind of almost like a hibernation type state called torpor during the winter months, where we might not see them for days or maybe even weeks at a time. You can see the way that Lincoln's prodding at my shoe there. They are quite curious as well. For an animal that's, I guess, quite popular and a lot of people do know them in Australia, there's still a lot that is quite mysterious about echidnas that we're still learning all the time. Thank you guys for taking part in our virtual echidna encounter today. I hope you've all learned something, and we hope to see you all at the sanctuary sometime soon so you can meet these echidnas in person. Thanks.